Technique is listening. Squeegee. And just sort of the cool thing that starts to happen. And again, this is one of those things that like you'll have a moment of clarity about this, and then you'll doubt it. But once you've had a moment of clarity about it, you're sort of had at that point. It'll keep. The moment of clarity will keep. It'll keep. It won't let you go back to as sleep as you were. It won't let you believe what you used to believe quite so much anymore. The point, remember, is to experience the truth of reality. To experience the truth of your reality. I'm saying that the totality is erupting as you. And that the technique is to just settle into yourself, and if you feel the truth of who you are, you'll start intuiting the truth of infinity, the universe. And I'm also saying that when you do it, when you relax enough and silent-minded enough to have a clear hit of the truth, luckily, it starts feeling lovely. And it starts feeling lovely because the energy is love. And it's often hard to talk about this without it sounding too hokey, but again, it's like, this is one of those things that, as yogis, we should be talking about this a little bit. Like, I wouldn't talk with everybody about, you know, love. I mean, I don't anyway, but like, you know, like here, when you start feeling the truth of who you are, and the reason that the practices are so good is like, they help erase the tension out of your body so that at the end of class in Shavasana or when you're sitting there, you just start feeling like the buzz of it. The energy is love. When you start feeling the energy that constitutes you, you start feeling loved by the energy. Now, I was lucky. I had a mother who, I felt totally loved by my mother. Like, totally. Like, no doubt. I had problems with my father. Not big ones, but enough to where it was sort of like, but mom was, you know, and I, you know, like as a little kid, I just remember being loved, held, supported, no doubt, no fear. And then for a lot of years it went away. And when I was a kid, I used to get what I used to call like a thrill of joy. I would just get these little thrills and I would say to mom, well, you know, I just feel good inside. I get this thrill of joy. And for a long time it went away, and I thought, oh no. You know, and like I missed it and was like feeling bad. And then when I started getting into the yoga and the meditation, it started coming back. And I realized, wow, what it is. It's like learning to like silent mind it. Let go of what you think you are. Let go of everything you've been taught. Because no matter what you've been taught, you still are what you are. The totality is still erupting as you. And when you silent mind it and you squeegee your mind and you be with the experience that's left, you start feeling loved by the energy. And you start feeling like, wow, yeah. Whew, thank God, yes. And then instead of life being the enemy, you start feeling, wow, life is like the awesome event.